Hey everyone, so welcome to the fourth lecture on the course Ordinary Differential Equation. So today we are going to see the third method that will help you to find solution of a first order linear differential equation. So the previous method which we saw were variable separable method and reduction to variable separable method. So I hope both the methods are clear. If not, you can have a look. I will be posting the link in the description. So the third method that we are going to see is exact differential equations. So we will see the concept of exact differential equations, and we will see how this concept helps us to find solution of a first order linear differential equation. So if you cannot apply variable separable or reduction to variable separable, this is a third method we'll look for to find the solution. So let's see what is the agenda for today's talk. So the first thing we are going to see is we will see a concept of total derivative, because we will need that to understand the concept of exact differential equation. Once we see both the things, I will take an example so that you will understand the definition. Then we will see a theorem which deals with the necessary and sufficient condition on when a differential equation is exact. And at the end, I will tell you a proper algorithm on how to find the solution. So this is what we are going to see in next 10 to 12 minutes. Okay, so let's see the first topic, which is nothing but the total derivative. So suppose if you have a function in two variables, say f is a function of two variables, say x and y, so which is x square y cube plus e raised to xy. Now the total derivative of f is denoted by df. So df means the total derivative of f. And how it is defined? It's defined as you take partial derivative of f with respect to x into dx plus partial derivative of f with respect to y into dy. So now in this case, if I take this as my function, then what would be my f with respect to x? So when you are differentiating with respect to x, we keep our y as constant. So here if I want to differentiate this with respect to x, so I treat y cube as constant and derivative of x square is 2x. So this whole thing multiplied by dx plus what is dy f by dy y? So if I want to differentiate this with respect to y, I will treat my x as constant. So this is what the total derivative is of this function. So I hope you know how to find the total derivative of a function. We will study this in detail when we will talk about, when we will study multivariable calculus. So as of now, you just make sure you know how to find total derivative of a function. So this is how we find. Well, this was for two variables. Suppose if we have three variables, suppose if you have this plus z square x into y. So now this is a function in three variables. And now you have, so how do we define total derivative now? We will define total derivative as this part plus dy f by dy z into dz. So three terms will come. That's how you find the total derivative. Now that's the first thing you need to comment. What we need to comment? You should tell me what is the total derivative of this function. Def of xyz equals x square y cube plus e raised to xy plus z square into xy. You can pause the video and you can comment right now. So this is the first thing you need to do. Okay, now let's go on to our second topic.
Okay, before telling you what do you mean by an exact differential equation, we need to observe one fact. Now what is that fact? Look, in the previous lecture we saw that any first order linear differential equation can be written in this form, dy by dx equal to some function of x and y. Okay, that was one thing. Now when we deal with exact differential equation, we will rewrite this in a different form. Now let me take an example. Suppose if this is equal to x cube y upon x square plus y raised to 10. Now what I can do is I can get rid of the denominator. What I want to say is I can rewrite this as, I bring this over here, I bring this over here, and I bring the term on the left hand side onto the right hand side. So I can always rewrite any first order linear differential in this form. Some function of x and y into dx plus some function of x and y into dy equal to 0. So in general what I want to say is you can also rewrite any first order linear differential equation as this way, some function of x and y into dx plus some function of x and y into dy equal to 0. So whenever we have a first order linear differential equation, we first try to solve it by variable separable method. If not, then we go for reduction to variable separable method. If not, this is the third method we will attempt, which is called as the exact differential equation. And whenever we want to apply this method, we always rewrite our differential equation into this form. Okay, so make sure if you are applying this method, you rewrite your differential equation into this form. Okay, now let's see what when you say a first order linear differential equation to be an exact differential equation. Okay, so suppose we have a first order linear differential equation and which is written in this form. Now when I will call this equation, let me give it a name, equation 1. So when I will call this to be an exact differential equation, if there exists, this is a symbol for there exists, if you are able to find a differentiable function u means u is a function of x and y, such that when I take the total derivative of u, I get the differential form. When I take the total derivative of u, I get the left hand side of the differential equation. If such a thing happens, then I will call equation 1 to be a exact differential equation. And if such a thing exists, then what will be our solution? So if I call this as 2, and from 1 and 2, what do I get? I get du equal to 0, because this quantity is equal to 0. And when I integrate both sides, I get u of xy equal to c. So if you are able to find the function u such that its total derivative is equal to the left hand side of equation 1, then u equal to c, this is called as the general solution of the differential equation 1. So once we find u, our job is over. Why? Because u equal to c is the solution. And if you recall, when you call something to be a solution, if you differentiate, you should get the differential equation, right? So if I take the derivative on both sides, here the derivative is 0, it's constant. And here derivative means I am talking about total derivative. When I take the total derivative of this u, I get nothing but the left hand side. So I get left hand side equal to 0. And therefore this u is called as a solution. Because when I am differentiating, I am getting my differential equation. So these three lines is when you call a differential equation to be an exact. And once you find your u equal to c is the solution. Now let's take an example so that this concept will be more clear. Okay, so this is a differential equation I have. My job is to find the general solution for this first order linear differential equation. So what is the first thing I do? The first thing I do is I check whether I can use variable separable. No, I can't do. I can't separate the variables over here. Second thing, can I use reduction to variable separable? No, right? Because this is not homogeneous. If you recall, if this is homogeneous, then you can do by reduction to variable separable. So both the methods are not applicable over here. So we'll try to go by the third method. Okay, so now what I will do here, I will rewrite this into mdx plus ndy equal to 0 form. So what do I get here is e raised to y into dx plus 2y x e raised to y dy equal to 0. So your m is e raised to y, your n is 2y plus x e raised to y. Now if you take your u equal to y square plus x e raised to y, and if you try to find its total derivative, what will be total derivative? Du equal to u with respect to x into dx. So I get e raised to y into dx plus u with respect to y into dy. So it is nothing but 2y plus x e raised to y dy. So this is what the total derivative is. So for this function, I am getting the left hand side of the differential equation. That means what? This differential equation is an exact differential equation. And whenever you have an exact differential equation, what is the solution? Your solution is u equal to c. Now u equal to c means what? Y square plus x e raised to y equal to c. This is the general solution for this differential equation. So once you have your u, your job is done, because u equal to c is the solution. So that's how one can take the help of exactness to find the general solution. Okay, now one can ask two questions over here. The first question, when will I know that such a u exists or not? Okay, so here I gave you directly take u as this. But then, what is the guarantee that such a u exists? If it is not guarantee, then question is, when will it exist? Do you have any theorem or so that will tell you, okay, under so and so condition, your u will exist? Okay, so the first question is, when your u will exist? Second question, if such a u exists, question is, how to find that u? Okay, so existence and finding the u. These are the two questions which one can ask. So for existence, we will see a next theorem. I won't take a proof, I will just state, which is called as the necessary and sufficient condition for exactness. So let's see that theorem first. So here is the answer to our first question, which is nothing but necessary and sufficient condition. So what the theorem says, it says that if we have a first order linear differential equation, when I will call this to be an exact, that means when that u will exist. It says it exists if and only if you take m with respect to y and you take n with respect to x. When both the things are equal, then such a u will always exist. Okay, so this is called as an existence theorem. It says that whenever you have these two things equal, then your u will definitely exist. U means which u? When you take its total derivative, you get this mdx plus ndy. And in that case, what will be your solution? U equal to c will be your solution. So this is one of the very important theorem which gives you the necessary and sufficient. That means what? If this is exact, then this condition is satisfied. And if this condition is satisfied, then this is exact. That's why necessary and sufficient condition. Okay, now, so our first question is answered that under this condition, our u exists. Now question is how to find that u. So I will tell you a very nice algorithm. I will take this with the help of an example so that the concept will be clear. So let's take the same example which we took initially, where I gave you u directly. Okay, so now this is the differential equation. What is my m? The coefficient of dx, which is nothing but e raised to y. What is my n? It is coefficient of dy, which is nothing but 2y plus x e raised to y. Now the first thing we will check whether u exists or not, or whether this is an exact differential equation or not. So for that we will use our theorem. So we will try to find dabba m by dabba y and dabba m by dabba x, and let's see whether they are equal or not. So what is dabba m by dabba y? Differentiate this with respect to y. It is e raised to y itself. Differentiate this with respect to x. So this term will become 0 and this will become e raised to y. So what do we get? This is another notation. So what do we get is m with respect to y is same as n with respect to x. Therefore, 1 is an exact differential equation. What is 1? This is equation 1. So I know that u exists. Now question is how to find that u. So as the given differential equation is an exact differential equation, what do we have? We have by definition there exists u such that when I take the total derivative, I get the left hand side of the differential equation. That means I get the differential form. So this is what I have. Why such a thing exists? Because m with respect to y is same as n with respect to x. Okay, now simply apply the definition. What is this? Du is nothing but dabba u by dabba x into dx plus dabba u upon dabba y into dy equal to the right hand side. This is what the definition is of total derivative. Now if I equate both sides, what do I get? We get dabba u by dabba x is equal to e raised to y, the coefficient of dx, and the coefficient of dy, which is nothing but u with respect to y equal to this thing. Now I have to use these two equations to find what is our u. Okay, so till here it was the definition. Here I have simply equated, so we have not done anything new. Now the question is how to find u. So to find u, what I will do is I will integrate equation 1 with respect to x. So when I integrate 1 with respect to x, what will be my left hand side? By fundamental theorem of calculus, my left hand side will be nothing but only u, because integration of derivative is nothing but the integrand. So when I integrate both sides with respect to x, what do I get is u of xy, because integration of derivative is the integrand, which is u, equal to, I'm integrating with respect to x, so e raised to y is constant, one integration is x plus a constant. Now here one thing you need to keep in mind, that since we are in two variable, instead of only writing k, it will be k of y. So here your constant is not a number, it can be any function of y. Why so? Because what I want, when I differentiate this with respect to x, I should get my equation 1. So when I differentiate this with respect to x, I get e raised to y. Plus if it is constant, still it is 0. If it is a function of y, still it is 0. Right? So whenever we are in two variables, make sure you be careful while integrating. Only a single constant won't come. So when the constant will come? When you have a function in one variable. Whenever you have a function in two variable, when you are integrating with respect to one variable, in constant, not only constant will come, some other variable will also come into picture. Because when I differentiate this with respect to x, I am getting the equation 1. So this is what I have now. Let me call this as equation 3. Now to find u, I have this thing. Question is, what is k of y? So now to find u is sufficient to find my k of y. Now I have used the first equation. I have not yet used the second equation. So to use the second equation, I should know what is dabba u by dabba y. So differentiate this with respect to dabba u by dabba y so that I can use equation 2. So what is dabba u by dabba y? It is nothing but x e raised to y plus k is a function of only one variable, which is y. So instead of writing dabba, I am writing dk by dy. Let me call this as equation 4. Now if I equate 2 and 4, because 2 is what? U with respect to y equal to something. 4 is what? U with respect to y equal to something. So if I equate equation 2 and 4, what do I get? X e raised to y plus dk by dy equal 2y plus x e raised to y. And now as you can see, you can cancel x e raised to y from both sides. And now when I integrate with respect to y, here what do I get? K of y equal to y square plus c1. Now here I will write c1. Why? Because k is a function of only one variable y. So when I integrate, I have only constant. So I got my ky. Now I will substitute the value of k in equation 3. So what do I get? So this is what my u is. X e raised to y plus y square plus c1. Great. So we got our u. So once you have our u, you can verify actually. You differentiate this with respect to x, you should get your m. You differentiate this with respect to y, you should get your n. You do those things. If things, both the equations are satisfied, that means this is your required u. And therefore, what is the solution? Your solution is u of xy equal to c. That means what? X e raised to y plus y square plus c1 equal to c. Now what you can do is you can take your c1 on the right hand side and you call c minus c1 as some another constant. Okay, so ultimately what we do is, since we can always ignore this c1 as a constant because we can combine the constants at the end, what we do is we take here c1 as 0. So when we integrate dk by dy, here instead of writing c1, you don't write c1. You can write down c1 and then you can say, for simplicity, let's take c1 equal to 0. Once you take c1 equal to 0, this will be your u, no problem. Again, you differentiate this with respect to x and this with respect to y, you get your m and n respectively. So that does not affect the solution. And here also, no need to write c1, because ultimately if you take that over here, again c minus c1, you call another constant, say capital C. So what do we do is, we never write c1 over here. When we integrate k, we only write the function, we take c1 to be 0. So this is what our solution is to the given differential equation. And if you recall, this is what I gave you at the starting. So this is an algorithm or a method to find u. You write down two equations, u with respect to x, u with respect to y. You integrate first equation, whatever answer you get, you differentiate that, you do some calculation and you get your answer. Okay, so that's about exactness. Here are the two examples which I would like you to solve. Both examples cannot be solved using variable separable or reduction to variable separable. That's what I guess. If they can, well and good. But then I want you to solve using exactness. So first check whether they're exact or not by checking the condition whether m with respect to y is same as n with respect to x or not. And once you are done with that, you use the algorithm to find your u. And as usual, at the end, you comment answers for both the questions so that it will help others to verify. Thank you and have a nice day.